one that's probably the most popular right now, like in Hollywood, because they have someone doing it for them. What I like to do is sort of choose a side and then kind of sweep it across the front. Okay, so you want to start a bit further back. Like, of course, you could start right here, but around the hairline, the hair is very fine. So you're not going to get a very, you're not really going to see the braid very much. So like I said before, as I add hair, the braid gets thicker and thicker. So you'll see me do that. So I want to start back here. So there's a small skinny that's getting thicker and thicker and thicker as we work across. So there's two ways to do a French braid. So a normal one, if you're doing it on someone else, this is the most natural way to do it, is crossing over. So this piece is crossing over. This piece is crossing over. If you want to have the braid that shows off more, you want to do an inside-out French braid. So all that means is rather than crossing over, I'm going to cross under. So I'm going under. And each section, I need to pick up some more hair. This is the French braid. This is the tricky part. So you've got to maintain your tension while adding hair into the section. And remember where you're coming and going from. And then at this point, you can keep on, you know, French braiding all the way around the head if you want, or you can secure elastic here, or you can braid it down through the ends. I think today we're going to braid it down to the ends. And this look, it's supposed to look a little bit messy. It's sort of like that country, sort of messy, sexy look. So you don't want to have anything too perfect. So it's kind of takes the pressure off when you're doing it on yourself. Kind of just got to keep going, you know. And when I do it on myself, I find it can be quite frustrating. Your arms get tired. But if you worry about trying to get something perfect, it never sort of works out. But if you just kind of, you sort of lose it, but keep going. It's the best thing, just to keep going and go, okay, I like this messy sort of look. So I'm just securing the end with an elastic. So she can go ahead and wear it just like this, or she can bring the ends of this back up and do another, like, crossover to make it look a little bit funner. And again, you're just going to pin and secure in. And you always want to kind of tuck it, so that way it looks